Hey sis, it's Carron. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video and just welcome in general if you are new to my channel. So as you can tell from the title of this video, today we're gonna be talking about chlorophyll and how it can help you shrink fibroids, reduce period pain, and reverse anemia. So let's jump right into it. And I have my smoothie here with me. I am going to be kind of drinking this and sipping on this throughout this video. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so chlorophyll, if you're not familiar with chlorophyll, I'm just gonna hit you with the scientific definition of chlorophyll. You guys know I like to hit you with a little bit of knowledge, educate you guys so that you guys can empower and just live a healthier lifestyle. So the scientific definition or the scientific term for chlorophyll is a green pigment present in all green plants that's responsible for the absorption of light to provide energy for photosynthesis. So, in plain English, chlorophyll is basically what makes green plants green, what gives plants that beautiful green hue, what gives them the energy from the sun to provide you with those vitamins, the minerals, and the nutrients that dark leafy greens and plants are pretty much known for. Now, some of the benefits of chlorophyll or increasing your chlorophyll intake are boosting up the immune system overall, detoxification. It's a blood builder. So if you're suffering from like anemia or low iron levels, chlorophyll is amazing for that. This is why it reverses things like anemia. So when you are low on chlorophyll, you can have like a lack of energy. Your body has a lesser ability to fight off sicknesses, illnesses, diseases, all sorts of things. So that's pretty much what the benefits of chlorophyll are. Another interesting fact real quick though of chlorophyll, it's also kind of like a natural deodorizer, because it gets rid of bad smells in the body, which makes sense because if chlorophyll helps your body to detoxify and remove that toxic waste kind of smells. So if you're eliminating toxins and waste from the body, you're also gonna stay fresher as well. So win-win, plus plus for chlorophyll. Now, what does chlorophyll have to do with shrinking fibroids? So if you increase your chlorophyll intake, again, you're gonna get those detoxification benefits. Your body's gonna help eliminate a lot of that waste. A fibroid is a waste, it's a lot of built up toxins. So by increasing your chlorophyll intake, you're also helping your body to expel and remove all of those toxins, including the fibroids. Again, also because the chlorophyll has high amounts of iron and vitamins and nutrients, when you have fibroids, and I'm sure a lot of you, you know, suffer from this, if you have fibroids, especially if you have large fibroids or if you have a lot of fibroids, the heavy bleeding, the heavy cramping that comes with it. Now, by increasing your chlorophyll intake, you are going to reduce not only the length and time of your periods. Some of you may have periods that last like 7 to 10 days. You can lessen the amount of days that you're on your period, lessen the cramping, and also lessen the bleeding. Now, if you're not suffering from a lot of blood loss, that means that you won't suffer from anemia as well. So the lighter your blood flow is, the more your body maintains and holds on to the iron. When you heavy bleed a lot and you have a lot of heavy bleeding, then you are losing a lot of blood and you're losing a lot of iron. So the chlorophyll, increasing your chlorophyll intake will replace a lot of the iron that you're losing with the heavy blood flow, and it'll also stop you from having a heavy blood flow and a heavy menstrual cycle. So again, win-win for the chlorophyll. Now, you might be asking, okay, so how do I get chlorophyll? Where do I get chlorophyll from? Again, chlorophyll is pretty much what makes plants green. So by eating more green leafy vegetables and fruits, you are getting your chlorophyll intake. Now, some people will supplement their chlorophyll, which is perfectly fine. There are liquid chlorophyll that you can buy at any health food store. I will leave a link in the description box if you're interested in purchasing liquid chlorophyll. I have purchased liquid chlorophyll as a supplement, not a substitute. It's important to note that because I do feel that you need to get your chlorophyll intake primarily from your diet. Again, your dark leafy green vegetables. But if you want to add on top of that, you can purchase a liquid chlorophyll substitute. Now, some people add like this plain liquid chlorophyll into water. I don't like to do that just because I'm not a fan of the taste of just plain chlorophyll and water. So if I do purchase like the liquid chlorophyll bottles, then what I like to do is just add it in to my recipes. For example, like today, and here's another way that you can get your chlorophyll intake: by drinking smoothies. So this is how I like to get a lot of chlorophyll into my diet, in addition to like eating salads and things. But I also drink a lot of smoothies with dark leafy green vegetables. So today, this smoothie is spinach. I got some wheatgrass powder in here, some frozen jackfruit, peaches, and some pineapples. So this is actually really, really good. I'm trying not to like sip on this entire time, but this is how I get my chlorophyll in a smoothie, and it doesn't even like really, you can't even really taste it like that. Another thing I like to add to my smoothies is spirulina powder. If you guys have been following me for a while, and if you follow me on Instagram as well, then you've seen me add spirulina powder to my smoothies. Spirulina is a algae green sea vegetable, which has a lot of vitamins, minerals in there, like vitamin B, iron, and chlorophyll, because it is super, super dark and it has that beautiful color in there. And that's really easy way to like just get those extra chlorophyll in there. And I will also leave a link in the description box if you're interested in purchasing some spirulina. I know a few people have said they have a hard time finding it, but you can definitely purchase it online, so be sure to check that description box. Another way is by juicing. You guys know that I absolutely love to juice. It is a daily or at least weekly habit of mine, juicing dark leafy green vegetables like your kale, your spinach, your bok choy, your dandelion greens, like collards, like any dark leafy green, juice that, because that is gonna give you so much chlorophyll. And juicing actually puts that good chlorophyll, those good nutrients, directly into your bloodstream. Your body doesn't have to digest something like a smoothie or a salad. If you really wanna get that pure liquid chlorophyll into your bloodstream, juicing is like the best way to go. You can also add like liquid chlorophyll drops into the juice that you make, but just drinking that raw green juice is gonna get you so much chlorophyll on its own. And again, I also have a juicing and smoothie recipe. If you're curious about and you need some extra like recipe ideas or inspiration, be sure to check out my juices and smoothies ebook. Again, I will leave that link in the description box below this video as well. Now, I also like to add like chlorophyll in different sort of recipes and things, and I like to add them to like my banana ice cream. You can make some really good things as well. Okay, so here's a quick mint chocolate chip banana ice cream recipe using chlorophyll. Taking 3 frozen mini bananas, 1 tablespoon of hemp seeds, 2 dates, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, and a few drops of liquid chlorophyll. This has the peppermint oil, which gives the mint flavor to the ice cream. Add all of that to your mini blender. Lastly, adding in some cacao or carob chips for the chocolate. This is a really simple and delicious way to add more chlorophyll to your diet. All right, ladies, so I'm gonna wrap it up here. I hope that you guys found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give me a big thumbs up. Also, I will leave the recipes that I shared with you for my chlorella dessert in the description box if you're curious about how to make that. And once again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you on the next one, of course. Later, sis.